What's China's move, a reaction to Trump here?
Well, there would be a reaction. There is a speculation that it would have been a reaction to what Trump had to say on Taiwan. And then there were other people speculating that it was a reaction to, you know, scooping this drone out of the water was a reaction to PACCOM commander Harry Harris.
Underwater vehicle.
Yes, that's right. And PACCOM commander Harry Harris was in Sydney last week talking to the Lowy Institute, and he made some remarks about the South China Sea, which could have been considered to be aggressive from the point of view of the Chinese. But to be honest, Rich, I don't buy either of those. I think this was purely opportunistic. There was a drone in the waters. The Chinese had an opportunity to seize the drone. They probably have been wanting to get hold of one of these drones for quite a while so that they could have a look at it.
Well, John McCain has said, what about reverse engineering here, of course?
Well, I mean, they've got their own drones, but I think they want to see what this US drone is. There's no record that, you know, these drones are available on the open market. You can buy one if you want one. But I don't think there's been any sold to the Chinese. And I think the Chinese probably pretty interested to see what this drone can do and maybe what was in its bank of data. So I think that was probably a purely opportunistic idea to come in there and scoop out that drone. And now they've agreed to, you know, eventually give it back to the US.
Well, and don't forget that Donald Trump also tweeted, keep the drone. You've got to ask, yeah. Is he doing damage here?
I mean, the
what
fact
is he
that he
doing?
Comes
he's
out...
stirring the pot.
Look,
certainly.
all of what he's done is extremely provocative. I mean, first of all, the Chinese taking the drone was provocative, but then Trump inserts himself into it, and what he says makes it even more provocative. And we've also seen what he had to say about the, you know, the One China policy in Taiwan, that was a risk. We've seen him accusing China of building the fortresses in the South China Sea and that the Chinese shouldn't be doing that. So he's constantly pushing. But remember, he's still a private citizen. He's the president-elect. He's not the president. China is continuing to sort of be muted in its response to all of these sort of cajoling from Trump. The real question will be, what will Chinese and what will be Trump and American policy towards China after he takes the presidency?